I'm just wondering how on earth you can be promoting transparency and free thought and even learning from things within your own organisation if you hold a veto over research, where you can require researchers to amend their findings if they're negative or not constructive, or you can blacklist them. How can that be encouraging sort of open, free research and exchange of ideas?
So what's happened in the last week has caused us to really have a look at our policy. It was possibly fit for purpose at one stage. It's not fit for purpose now. We work in a dynamic environment. So that's being reviewed as we speak, both the policy and the decision that was made in respect of Dr. Jared Gilbert. And I'm sure you'll hear more about our review of that next week. But it's also important to point out that the intent of that was to keep people's information private. And that's why we have some policies and rules.
But people who, public, who are looking at that would say, if they were to look at the agreement, that is more than protecting people's privacy. It's about keeping a lid on things that are negative for the police or may be perceived as negative for the police.
Yeah, that's why we will be changing the wording of that policy and what it's about, because the frustrating thing is, it's the opposite that's true in terms of where we're at the moment. We're wanting to build great relationships with academia, because we are determined to be a very evidence-based police service.